Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series, where we build the ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless, Active Directory, and much more. In the last video, we imported the VM into ESXi, and we were able to access the web interface. At that point, we ended up at the license screen, and from that license screen, we need to continue. So that's where we start off today. What we will do is we will install the licenses, we'll do the initial login, we'll configure the automatic updates, we will show you how to lock down the WebUI, and we will enable insight and log interim accounting, which also is important to do. So first we need to install the license, and licensing is unlicensed per appliance, so that's called the platform activation key, and afterwards we will have access licenses and onboard licenses and other licenses. We'll cover that later on. So for the platform activation key, you get that through the license management system. I have it already, and as you can see here, it's a string that starts with begin ClearPass platform license key, and it ends with that as well, and you just type it in here. So you can see this is also the end. So from the line begin and end, including it all, then here we need to agree to the terms and conditions again. And you can see that it's now installed. We need to activate the product, and at this time I would recommend to wait till we have everything installed. Only then we will activate the licenses, because after you activated them, you can't start over again, and for that reason, I would recommend this time not to do the activation. We'll do that later on. So the username is admin. So remember that for the CLI, it was app admin. For the UI, it's admin. And the password is the password that you set during the installation. This will get us in the first login. So what we can see here is that we have the new features that are in this version of ClearPass. So that's nice. We can click do not show again, not to show it again. The next step is that we will configure our updates. And updates are here under administration. Then we go here to the agent and software updates and to the software updates. What we need to do next is we need to authorize this ClearPass instance on our HPE passport credentials, which are the same we use for the Aruba support portal. So we need to generate a token here. Here we type our email address and our password. And remember, this is the same password we use to sign in, or the same account that we use to sign in to the Aruba support portal. And this has authorized the automatic updates. And you can see that we now can download updates. So the next step that we need to do is to lock down the WebUI. In order to do that, we go here to the server manager. This is where we can manage the ClearPass server. We can see here the ClearPass server. Also here we have a lot of global settings, the so-called cluster-wide parameters. This is where we can set up a lot of different options. So we'll leave them default for now. But in order to lock down the admin access, we can go in and we have the network settings here. So here we have application access control. And here I can, for example, allow for my policy manager, which is the web UI for ClearPass. And we can allow specific networks. So what we can do is we can allow 10.1.254.0/24 and another classes. And then we can only access the ClearPass web UI from this location. So we can see that, for example, I have a client here that's in the 10.1.10 range. So it's a different IP range. Let's try again. You can now see that we have a forbidden at this point. So we can only allow access, or we can only get access through the specific IP addresses. Next step is that we need to enable insight and log interim accounting. We'll need that for further and future labs, so let's do that as well. We can do that here under the service parameters. Here we go to the radio server, and here under the radio server you can see the log interim accounting update packets. It's set to false by default, so we enable it. We'll set it to true on the system. Here we have the options to enable Insight. Insight is the database that's storing all kinds of statistics, and we'll need that as well later on. We need to enable one server as the Insight primary server. We'll create a cluster in a few episodes, and at that point we'll make that the backup server, the secondary server. So we can see the server will be the primary server here. Also here we can change our IP addresses if we want, and so on. And we could join the server to the domain. Joining to the domain is only needed if we want to do EPEEP password authentication with the AD domain. And as that's deprecated, we'll not do that, at least not at this time. So we'll not be joining the AD domain. We will be using in this workshop EPTLS with client certificates. So we don't need to join the domain. Now we click save here, and that will save all these settings that we did at this point. So and now it's time to install the other licenses. We did install the platform activation key. The other license, we can do that here under administration licensing. We can see that we have the servers, we have the platform key installed already. So it's not activated as mentioned before. We can now here press add a license, and we can add the other licenses. So there are three types of licenses. We have the access license, which is the basic license for ClearPass. Then there are two add-on licenses, which are onboard and which are OnGuard. Onboard is for BYOD self-provisioning of client certificates of unmanaged devices. OnGuard is a posture agent, so you can do health checking on the client. You need the license for that. So let's first add the access license. So again, we need to agree to the terms and conditions. So now you can see we have an access license for 100 concurrent users. So it's a concurrent user license. And then let's add the other licenses as well. So this is my onboard license, as you can see. And finally, the OnGuard license. So policy manager OnGuard license. So here I agree. So I had a quote at the end that needs to be removed. And at this point, you can see that we have 100 licenses. So these licenses are shared across the cluster when we will build the specific cluster. So I have my platform license here. I have my subscription licenses for the access, onboard, and OnGuard, which is now called the compliance suite. I have them also here. So you can see it's a 1 year license, and the same here, we'll activate them once we know for sure that this deployment is all correct. Well, that's it for now. In the next video, we will be creating an HTTPS certificate on the ClearPass, so we don't see any certificate warnings anymore. And if you don't want to miss that video, please press the subscribe to our channel button at this point. If you like this video, please let us know by pressing the like button. And if you have questions, put them as comments under the video, and we're more than happy to help you out. That's it for now. Thanks a lot for watching.